All right, this is fifth grade module one, lesson four. And in this lesson, we're going to be doing some metric conversions. But the point is to continue practicing with our powers of 10. Now we're just happening to be doing it inside the context of metric conversions, as opposed to just doing it with plain old boring numbers. So let's get started on this. So the first thing I like to do before I just go teaching some sort of rule is to help students understand the basic relationships of the metric, various metric measurements. For example, I start off with that big old meter stick, and I show them that 1 meter, this whole length, is the same thing as 100 centimeters. And then I show them that 1 little centimeter is the same as 10 millimeters. So that means if you have 1 meter, you're going to have a lot of millimeters. There's 10 here, 10 here, 10 here, all the way, and there's 100 of them, so 100 times 10. And once you get this basic idea of the general relationships, that's how I teach the relationships of these metric conversions. I don't try and teach them just some boring rule. So let's get practicing that. So the idea is convert and write an equation with an exponent. Use your meter strip when it helps you. So it just so happens I have a meter strip right here. I'm going to shrink that a little bit. Boom. All right. And the idea is, it says 2 meters is equal to how many centimeters? Well, if you have 1 meter, that's 100 centimeters. So if you have another meter, that's another 100 centimeters. So that's why it's 200. So you have 2 meters times by 100, and that gives you 200. So let's do this problem B. So you have 108 centimeters, and we want to know how many meters is that? Well, we know that if you have 100 centimeters, that equals 1 meter. So that's 100 centimeters divided by 100 gives you 1 meter. So if you have 108, that means, and I'm going to zoom in here, so if you have 108 centimeters, that means you're going to do 108 divided by 100, but that's the same thing as 108 divided by 100 to the second power. And that's really what they want us to give them. And then that equals, whoa, that equals 1.0, whoa, 1.08. And that's because the decimal moved 2 places to the left, because we divided by 100. So let's zoom out so that you can see all that going on right there. And that's the kind of concept going on this series of problems. Let's do, another example here. Let's do question D, which is saying 50 centimeters to how many meters? Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put in 50 centimeters. And in order to go from centimeters to meters, since meters are much bigger than centimeters, we're going to have fewer meters. And that means we're going to have to divide, and we're going to divide by 100. So that's going to be 50 divided by 100. But really what they want us to show is 50 divided by 10 squared. And that gives us 0.5. Oh, let's do one last one. Let's do E. So problem E says 6.3 meters. So we're going to write in 6.3 right here. And then if we want to turn that into centimeters, so that means we're going to have a lot of centimeters, because there's 100 centimeters that fits in each of these meters. So that means we're going to do 6.3 times 100, which is 6.3 times 10 squared, which means our answer is 630 because our decimal is going to move two places to the right. More of the same kind of practice, just a little less scaffolded. So there's my little representation that I like to use to help students understand. And if we're going to go from meters to millimeters, remember, 1 meter is going to have a bunch of these little millimeters. In fact, it's going to have 1,000 millimeters. So 4 meters into how many millimeters? Well, each meter has 1,000 millimeters. And another way to write that is 4 times 10 to the third power, which gives us 4,000. So our answer right here is 4,000. Oh my goodness. Now similarly, except the exact opposite, let's take a look at problem C. So now we have 1,050 millimeters. Okay, so that's 1,050 millimeters. And we want to turn those millimeters into meters. Well, when you have a lot of millimeters and you want to turn it into meters, since meters are big, much bigger than millimeters, that means you're going to have a smaller number of meters, which means you're going to take this number and divide. So we're going to take 1,050 and we're going to divide. And since there's 1,000 millimeters in a meter, we're going to divide by 1,000, which is to say 1,050 divided by 10 to the third power, which means our answer is going to be 1.050 because the decimal place moves 3 places to the left as our nice efficient shortcut. So that's going to be 1.050. Here it's just more of the same practice. I'm just going to kind of quickly go through this. Oh, let's take a look at question B. Question B says centimeters. You've got 7 centimeters, and we're going to turn it into meters. Well, since meters are big, that means we're going to have a smaller number of them to equal 7 centimeters. When, since there's 100 centimeters in a meter, means we're going to take that 7, we're going to divide by 100, which is to say 7 divided by 10 to the second power, and that means our answer is going to be 0.07 because that decimal is going to move 2 places to the left. Or you could think of it as the digits move 2 places to the right. And so our answer is 0.07. Now, a lot of teachers like to put the 0 in the front, and that's cool too. Oh, let's do one last one. Let's do D. So on D, we have 0.08 meters. Now, let's ignore the decimal. Let's just think about meters. You have meters, and then we want to turn it into millimeters. Well, since millimeters are small, and a whole bunch of them fit into a meter, in fact, 1,000 of them, that means this number right here is going to be big, because you're going to need a lot of millimeters to equal these meters. So we're going to take that 0.08, and we're going to multiply by 1,000. Because there's 1,000 millimeters in each meter. Another way of writing that is 0.08 times 10 to the third power. And remember, that means that decimal place moves 3 places to the right. So our answer becomes 80. Because we don't need that leading zero. We definitely need this trailing zero. So the answer is 80. All right, let's practice with some word problems. You've got Yi Ting, and his height is 1.49 meters, and we're supposed to express his measurement in millimeters. Well, meters are big, millimeters are small. We're going to have 1,000 millimeters for every meter. And which means this magnitude of the magnitude of this number is going to be big. You're going to have a lot of millimeters in order to equal the meters. So, it means we're going to have to multiply 1.49 times. In this case, it's going to be 1,000 because we know that there's 1,000 millimeters in 1 meter. So that becomes 1.49 times 10 to the third power, which means that decimal place is going to move. So that decimal place is going to move 3 places. It used to be here, and it's going to move 3 places to the right, which means we have to add in a zero. So our answer becomes 1,490 millimeters. And our last problem for this video is we've got a ladybug, and its length is 2 centimeters, and we're supposed to express this measurement in meters. Well, let's use logic. Centimeters are small, meters are big. In fact, there's 100 centimeters that fit into a meter. Since we want to convert into meters, and meters are big, which means this number right here is going to be a small number because you don't need very many meters to equal centimeters, these 2 centimeters. So our conversion, we're going to divide by 100 because we know that there's 100 centimeters in a meter. So 2 divided by 100 is the same thing as saying 2 divided by 10 to the second power. And that means we're going to take that 2, where the decimal is right here, and we're going to move that decimal place 2 spaces to the left, which means we have to add a 0. So it's going to be 0.02 meters is equal to 2 centimeters. And that wraps up 5th grade Module 1, Lesson 4, where we're using the metric system as the context for multiplying and dividing by 10, or multiplying and dividing by 100, or multiplying and dividing by 1,000.